near side. Two to the top side. Ertl looks over to the right, throws it up, and it's picked off. Intercepted by number seven, Nick Martin.
Yeah, he steered his receiver down. That was a quick, what looked to be a slant. Never really slanted, and Martin jumped the route. It looked like he knew what was coming before the receiver did.
Second down. Hand off this time to Martin again off the right side. Martin breaks it into the secondary. Picks up enough yards for a first down. So Nick Martin just puts his head down that time and drives forward. Sanchez and Martin, right to left on your screen. Hand off again to Martin off the left side, crashing forward, and he's going to be in for the touchdown.
Yep, that was just effort right there. Took the hand off, put his head down, bowled his way through a couple defenders, and it's a quick lead for Amesbury, less than 2 minutes in.
Arsenal hands off inside to Sanchez, who blows off the left side and is going to be in for the two-point conversion.
Yep. So that drive and the two-point conversion, nothing fancy. It was just power football.
Ertl, high snap, looking to keep it. Ertl is going to be pursued in the back, makes a nice cut, but gets back to the line of scrimmage, probably picks up a yard on the play. A high snap.
Nope.
And up inside and hitting the backfield. Beautiful pursuit. Two receivers to the top, near side, one to the top side. Dade, the lone back, man in motion. Pitch back to the man in motion, and he's hit by Martin. Another high snap, again, hand off to Day. Day is hit in the backfield and dropped nicely. Beautiful tackle that time by Mr. Andrew Baker.
Slow developing play. It looked like he was looking for a sweep of some sort, and Baker just blew by everybody.
.239 remaining here in this first quarter. Amesbury 7, Hamilton 8, Amesbury. Hand off to Day in the backfield. Day is tripped up, and I'm sorry, that's number 38, Collins.
Yeah, and Aiden Donovan just stood him up.
One near side and one in the slot. Passing formation here for the Generals. Ertl quickly out into the flat. The pass is complete and good coverage by Amesbury, and penalty flag is thrown again. Let's see what happens. It's going to be holding against Hamilton Wenham. So. Right, back into the backfield. Hand off to Day. He's hitting the backfield. Bounces off the one tackle and is dropped. Ainsbury is going to recover here on downs. Just some great pursuit that time. Hand off inside and cracking through there is number one, Luke Arsenal. A great fake into the line that time. Looked like Martin had the ball. And Arsenal scampers for 5, 10, 15, 20 yards. Hand off to Martin off the right side. Martin breaks it into the secondary. Almost breaks it all the way. But a good tackle out there by number 22, Alec Cody for Hamilton Wynnum. Nice run though by Martin again. For Hamilton Wynnum from their own 14-yard line. John Ertle at quarterback. Spread formation again. Ertle looking over to his right. This time he's going to be hit and still on his feet, but he is smacked. Big hit from the blind side that time. Hand off to number two, O'Neill. O'Neill's got some running room. Nice piece of yardage by number two, Henry O'Neill that time. Second and a long seven for Ainsbury. Hand off on the right side to Martin. Martin again into the secondary is tripped up from behind. So Martin is doing an excellent job here for Ainsbury tonight. Hamilton Wynnum is cranking it up in there. Inside to left goes O'Neill. O'Neill to the outside, cuts back inside the 10-yard line.
For another first down!
That was another one. He was able to get through the line and then immediately bounce outside. You know, he had the power to get through the line, the speed to get outside, and that make a guy or two miss.
Hand off to Martin, now on the right side. Martin cuts back in and he's in for the touchdown. So Martin scores his second touchdown of the night.
Yeah, easy, another one of those, sweep around the tackle, spun off a couple guys, and there was not much he could really do about it.
Hand off to number one, Luke Arsenal. Scoots right through the middle for a two-point conversion.
Left in the first half.
Which they did do, and they get the ball here to start the second half. Nice kickoff. Ball is picked up around the 10-15 yard line, and scooting up to the middle, looking to go through the hole and trying to drive forward is O'Neal. And what a run back that time by number two, Henry O'Neal.
No hesitation, and that was perfect.
Back for Rainsbury. Hand off over to the left side and looking for some daylight as O'Neal blasting through one tackler. Good 9-yard run that time by number two, Henry O'Neal. It's a keeper by Sheldoni, and Sheldoni gets enough for the first down and more.
First down!
Yeah, excellent fake handoff there, and the guy he faked it to was clearing a hole, almost functioning as a fullback, and was able to give him the first down.
Sheldoni looking to pass again. He's going to keep it. He's going to run around the left side looking to get in there, and he bounced out of bounds here. We'll see where they spot this one. He took a big hit off the outside there. Three receivers to the top side, two to the near side. Ertl looking to pass. He's got plenty of time. Here comes the rush, and he's going to be hit and dropped.
Yeah, that was a jailbreak at the end there. Amesbury has done great. That's a coverage sack, by the way. You can't put that on the line. They had everybody covered perfectly. He had nowhere to go, and they absolutely buried him.
Not afraid to put the ball in the air. He's going to run with it. It's a keeper. Tearaway jersey picks up a tough 3-4 yards. Unless Ertl decides to run. Ertl looking again. We got a penalty flag on the play. And again, nice defense by Amesbury. Who's that, number seven?
Nick Martin.
Martin on the tackle out there.
And I think they got the holding call that time.
Hamilton won him 0. Hand off over here to O'Neill. O'Neill tries to get outside, turns the corner, puts his head down, and rolls over the defender. Sheldon, the quarterback, handoff inside, and trying to break it is, excuse me, number 20, Sanchez that time. Yard line of Hamilton Wenham. Hand off to Martin. Martin gets to the outside, gets a block, and powers forward enough, I believe, for another first down. And up inside to number 2, O'Neill. O'Neill again into the secondary and enough for a first down.
Easy first down.
Good fake again that time by the quarterback. Quarterback. Barking signals. Hands off to number 7, Martin. Martin cuts back in the middle. Martin inside the 10-yard line, and again enough for a first down. Martin, Sanchez, and O'Neill in the backfield for Ainsby's. Sheldoni at quarterback. Handoff to number 2 inside. Driving forward, cracking in. And just, he's in for the touchdown. Once again, the officials are a little slow making calls here.
Yeah. Just another, right up the middle, crack him in the mouth. And that is 6.
Sanchez and Martin. Yeah, you called it. Sheldoni's going to fire. He throws in the end zone, and it's good for the 2-point conversion. Number 8, Baker. Good call, Ed.
I think we might see a squib here.
Line drive shot. Again, nice kick. That's going to have to be picked up. Number 8.
That's a great tackle.
James Ertl, the quarterback. Yeah. Two to the right, top and bottom. Ertl looks quickly, looking yes. over here to his right. Once again, a little pressure coming, and he's going to be hit from behind again.
Number nine
over there for Rainsbury.
And Capone.
Second and eight for Rainsbury. Pitched out to the left side. O'Neill breaks a tackle down the sideline and runs himself out of bounds after a first down. Great play that time. Nice call that time by head coach Colin McQueen. Sheldoni up over the ball. Hand off this time to O'Neill. Again, he's going to break in there to the secondary. He has enough for a first down. Arsenal checks into the backfield for Rainsbury. Hand off inside again to Martin. Martin crashing through there, taking players with him and bouncing and driving and enough for another first down, I believe. That was a good 17, 18 yards. He's got to have 100 yards tonight.
Absolutely at this point. Now, Martin, what he's really good at, he'll get past the defensive line and then find a secondary hole, bounce it back in usually. But he's good at bouncing it off and finding another seam to get another 5 or 6 yards.
Not afraid to hit the opposing defender either.
Nope, not one bit.
In the backfield. Hand off this time to number two. Henry O'Neill on the outside. O'Neill is going to be in for the touchdown. So another nice 17-yard run by O'Neill. See who they give the ball to this time, if anybody. This time, Arsenal right up the middle, touchdown.
Yeah,
just delayed the inevitable there.
O'Neill, Arsenal, and Martin again in the backfield. Hand off to number two. Dancing to the left side is O'Neal, and he's in for the two-point conversion. High snap again, handoff inside, and good hit at the line of scrimmage there by Amesbury.
Yeah, they fired off and didn't let him get anywhere. Your final score, Amesbury 32, Hamilton Wenham, don't it.
All right, we'll be back here next week as Amesbury will take... Hand off to nobody. Ciamattaro takes it, gets hit at the line of scrimmage, picks up the... Yada two.
For a game of about three.
Yep, that was a keeper all the way. It looked like he had a pitch option, but decided to turn it upfield quick. Nick Martin was able to sniff it out and stop him before he wasn't really able to get going.
Ciamattaro hands off to number five, Piers Sochinski. He's going to pick up possibly a yard back. First and 10 from the Amesbury 44-yard line. Ciamattaro with another keeper. He's going to be hit at the line. Drek still powering forward, though, and gets a push from behind and a push back. Ciamattaro at quarterback. Hands off to first back through, and he's not going to make it as Amesbury crashes in there and stops Rodriguez. Rodriguez, the up back, Pietrzyczynski, the deep back. Hand off to Pietrzyczynski. He's hitting the backfield and dropped. Good defense that time by Amesbury. His host of tacklers converged on him that time. Interesting little setup here, but I'm sure they will come back into the line of scrimmage, although that's not necessarily the case.
Good to snap it to him.
And they don't. And a good tackle outside there that time by Martin, number seven. So Martin jumped right on that one.
Yep, he was not fooled at all. That was the rare snap that wasn't between someone's legs either, because he just kind of ladled it back. To the running back there, Rodriguez, but Martin was not fooled at all and was able to snuff that out and keep it to a 6-0 game.
Yeah. First play from scrimmage. Hand off to number set two on the outside, O'Neal. The race is on. O'Neal tries to cut back, and he's finally dropped down about the 41-yard line.
It looked like Triton had some problems identifying who had the ball there, and by the time they figured out it was O'Neal, he was already romping into the secondary.
Arsenal gets way down low there. Hands off to the first back through and breaking it is Sanchez into the secondary. Very close to a first down. I think he has enough. We'll see where they spot it.
First two were just kind of quick hitters and they were slow to react.
Another first down for Amesbury. Hand off this time to Martin. Martin crashing off the right side. Powers forward again for some tough yardage. Picks up a good 5 yards on that play.
The injury line's having their way on offense so far.
Hand off inside and scooting into the end zone, untouched, number two, Henry O'Neal.
Yep, that was one of those trap plays. Handed off to the outside back who came back inside, made one little move and romped in. That was pretty easy.
Hand off to nobody, rolling to his left, firing into the end zone and complete to number nine, Damon Capone.
All right, yep. So he had the run pass option there, cutting against the grain as per usual.
Donovan will address the ball here for Amesbury. Picked up by the up man again by Triton, and almost clothesline, but met by a host of tacklers that time. Good coverage by Amesbury. Mataro looking to throw the ball again, rolls out to his left side. Here comes the pressure from Avery. He's got plenty of time here. Still plenty of time. Throws it back towards the middle, and it's going to be incomplete. Big pile up there in the middle of the field, and some nice work by number 20, Sanchez, that time to break that play up.
We'll be right back.
Hand off to nobody. Arsenal throws a pass and it's complete. Sanchez down to O'Neal. And O'Neal is probably finally knocked down. What a fake again into the line of scrimmage that time by Luke Arsenal. And Arsenal whipped that one a good 35 yards in the air. So Luke Arsenal with a great play. And that's going to be the end of the first quarter. We came right back and scored. Arsenal hands off to Martin around the right side. Martin breaks one tackle and powers forward again for some good yardage. Second and four. Pitch back this time to Sanchez. Sanchez breaks a tackle, heading to the outside, and
he's pushed out of bounds.
Finally driven out of bounds as he bounced off the tackler who knocked him out of bounds here. But nice piece of running again, another first down. Martin, Sanchez, and O'Neal. Hand off inside, and walking in is number seven, Nick Martin.
That's a touchdown!
Woo. That looked so easy that you didn't think he had the ball until he was handed it to the ref. They just paved the hole for him, and he basically skipped through.
Otaro looking to pass, fires it out here in the backfield. Good move again by, nice hit that time.
Or a quick kick, the only other thing you can figure.
Sam Otaro looking to pass. He's going to break a tackle into the secondary, but he's going to be short of the first down.
Yeah, it looks like he didn't find someone open really quickly.
Off to Martin, right up the middle. Arsenal breaks it down the left-hand sideline. Arsenal still on his feet and is finally driven out of bounds. So Luke Arsenal blasted up the middle that time for a good 40-yard run, I'd say.
Yep, just about.
Saldoni back in at quarterback. Hand off to nobody. Sheldoni looking to get outside. Expire is over and just shy of the...
They call him short.
I thought he rolled over the defender and almost got there.
We have Mod and Sanchez and I believe O'Neill in there. Handoff to number two right up the middle, and O'Neill is in for the touchdown.
Nothing fancy there. Handoff to O'Neill and time to run through a couple people. He did, and that is another touchdown.
Donovan this time boots it down, takes the little bounce.
He drops it, picks it up.
Ooh.
Hunter Belial on special teams there was a homing pigeon basically in that one.
To the near side, looking to pass again. This time he's hit in the backfield and breaks away from a tear apart jersey, and he will not go down. But finally, what an unbelievable effort that time by Max Ciremitaro.
Yeah, he did his best, but you know, Christian McGarry had the finishing blow there to get the sack.
Ciremitaro throwing it again, looking for the end zone in the corner, and it's going to be incomplete. Great move by Sanchez again defensively. Trayton knocking on the door here. Ciremitaro looking to throw the ball again. He's going to fire it, and it's going to be incomplete again. Nice defense over there. The Sanchez brothers doing a nice job here in the strong safety area. And Rodriguez comes back into the pot. Hand off to Piaseczki, and he's not going to make it.
Well, they brought Rodriguez back from the slot to be the lead back on that play, and they just ran into a big wall of red.
Ciremitaro out in there, flat to number two, Nolan. Nolan's going to be hit and dropped. Sanchez. Sanchez. from their own 40-yard line. Hand off this time to Martin, looking for some daylight. Martin makes it into the hole and picks up some great yardage, enough for a first down. And a good open field tackle that time as he was taken down from behind.
That was another one of those off tackle plays.
Arsenal, barking signals. Hand off to Martin. Martin breaks it again into the secondary. He's going to have enough for another first down. Sanchez and Martin, top to bottom here, bottom to top. Martin, nobody. Arsenal's going to keep the ball. He's going to win, speaks away from one tackler, and picks up enough for a first down, and he was smacked. But I tell you, Luke pops right up.
I think that's a circle button on Madden there with that spin move. You know, came around, spun right off the eye. Yeah, I got the first down.
Third down for Amesbury. Hand off to Martin. Martin crawls his way in there very close again. Let's see where they spot this one.
And it looks like it'll be an Amesbury!
First down. Hand off to Arsenal. Arsenal skips and dips, heads toward the end zone, inside the 5-yard line. Once again. Wells backfield. Pitch this time to Arsenal. Arsenal's going to cut back in, and he's going to be in for the touchdown.
Yep. Nothing fancy there. Just the pitch out to Arsenal. Got a bunch of blockers out there. The other two backs were able to lead him in to the end zone for the six.
Man in motion, Samad.
Keep. And he's met by number 7, Nick Martin, right at the line.
Martin was right there. Take the air out of the ball a little bit here and just try to.
It's going to be an onside kick.
Falling on.
And good coverage again by Ainsby. Wow, that's the second time tonight. One by both of these teams here. Number 13 there, Hunter Belisle.
Yeah. The problem is Ainsby covered both kicks really well.
see if they go hard count again. Hand off to nobody, pitched out here in the back, and it's incomplete.
That's a live ball.
It's in play.
Because he threw it backwards. That's a live ball.
What's going on here?
So that was a live ball that he threw backwards, a lateral. So Triton picked up the run with it. Now, if that's a fumble and Ainsbury fell on it, it's a first down Ainsbury. But it depends on who has the ball, of course.
Whoa.
Yeah, so
that play will definitely make the highlight film for the fact of what it was.
Right.
Two possessions at one time.
Yep.
Arsenal and O'Neill. Hand off to Arsenal. Arsenal, Luke Arsenal, on with the races. Arsenal down the left sideline. It's going to be finally tackled after a nice piece of running again.
So I think you're going to see run pass option here.
Fourth and goal from the six. Still with the ball, Saldoni. Touchdown! I tell you, Edu. Nice call, Edu. Nice call, Edu.
Yeah, they did that rollout where he goes against the grain. But he had O'Neill, got the step, and threw it over in the corner. And
O'Neill got the touchdown, yeah, right?
It's not over, but they're in trouble. Triton is in trouble.
Big two-point conversion here. Cialdoni hands off to O'Neill, dives in.
And he pushes over the 2 points.
O'Neill gets the two-point conversion. Big, big two-point conversion.
That's what's known as an octopus. Same player getting the six and then the two. That was huge because now it's not a touchdown, PAT, and field goal game. They're going to need to get two touchdowns here to at least tie it.
Siniski goes into the ring. This time, Ciamorato is going to be sacked.
Great play by the injury. Yeah,
the Triton line finally cracked there. Looked like Martin was there. Looked like McGarry was involved on that.
Very, very important also. Triton has no timeouts. Martin with the recovery.
I think someone took off early crossed the line for Triton before the kick was actually kicked.
That should be the ball game as the clock will run out. Outstanding, outstanding competition this evening. Both teams deserve credit. Both teams' offensives were absolutely explosive. The defense has actually played well also, despite the score.
Because, they did.
There were a lot of plays that could have gone either way. And, backs deep for Ipswich, getting underway here. Going to be a good kick over to the right-hand side here. Picked up and looking for some running room, but there's no place to go, and Spaling is dropped down by a host of tacklers. Call it second and about three. Pitch back to the right side. Coming around here is number 11, Matt McGowan. McGowan is going to be driven out of bounds. Going to be shot, I believe, at the first down. Shotgun formation, two receivers to the top side, hand off to number 7, Henry Wright. Henry is going to be mowed down by a plethora of tacklers that time, so he got no place.
Christian McGarry was there to lead the charge there.
Both right there. Right in the backfield. Elliott, long call, looking to pass, flips it out here to Henry Wright on the side, and he's going to be smacked immediately by good old number 1 that time, Luke Arsenal. Once again, two backs in the backfield for Ipswich. Little mishandoff at the in the exchange that time. We'll see if they get this playoff here. Clock is running with 5 seconds left here in this first quarter. And that's going to do it. So time will run out in the first quarter with the score. Amesbury 16, Ipswich nothing. Hand off over to the left side, looking for some daylight. Cutting back into the middle. Good piece of yardage that time.
Henry O'Neill on.
Third and one for Ainsby. Saldoni in there at quarterback. Handoff to the first back through and powering forward is Arsenal, who goes into the backfield. Drew Saldoni in there for Ainsbury. Hand off to Martin around the right side, cuts back in, gets into the secondary, breaks two tackles, and is finally knocked down after a first down. So good running again inside the Ipswich 40-yard line. Let's call it about the 38. Handoff inside out to O'Neill. O'Neill breaks it to the outside. One defender tries to go through him, but again, a nice piece of running that time by number 2, Henry O'Neill, one of the co-captains this year, along with Luke Arsenal for Ainsbury. Hand off to Martin into the secondary again. Oh, check that. Oh, big fake out that time. Who's that, Saldoni?
Saldoni.
All the way in. I apologize, folks. He faked out everybody, including us, which doesn't take too much to do, but great piece of running on a 20-yard scamper keep by Drew Saldoni.
I mean, that was the quality of the fake right there that everybody in the stadium thought that Arsenal had the ball there, except Saldoni, who just romped in, unmolested down the right sideline.
Ainsbury going for two. Hand off to Arsenal. Arsenal cracks off the left side and is in for the two-point conversion.
Yep. So.
In motion Hand off again to the first back through Wright, but Wright is hit at the line of scrimmage and wrestled down. Picks up a tough yard and a half.
Yep, they fired off the line very well there.
Man in motion, right to left, pitch back to the right. Good blocking on the outside and an outstanding tackle that time by number 25 for Amesbury, Maximus Sanchez, who's been in on a couple of nifty tackles here so far for Amesbury.
He had some Maximus speed coming from his safety spot there because he came from the deepest part of that secondary.
Pitch back over here to the left side, looking for some daylight, looking for a block. Good block is out in front of him. Up the sideline goes number 20, Sanchez.
That's the speed of Sanchez right there. Just a simple sweep.
Pitch back this time to the left side. Here comes Sanchez again. Sanchez plowing forward and is pushed forward for, I believe, another first down.
Yep, not just the speed guy. He used the speed to, you know, get some yardage there, but he also was able to bowl through for a few extra yards. I think Amesbury's eager to get another touchdown here before the half. As whether they get the two or not, they'll be up by 30, and I think that triggers the running clock for the second half.
Buck 10 to go. Hand off to the first back through. No, fired out here, and it's complete to Sanchez. Sanchez is hit from behind. Wow, what a great open field tackle that time by Henry Wright, number 7, as... Coach McQueen running down the side down, calling his final timeout, I believe. Score, Amesbury 24, Ipswich 0. Martin, Sanchez, and O'Neill in the backfield. Pitch back this time to Sanchez again. Sanchez looking for a block, gets one on the outside and is driven out of bounds. Smart move that time by Sanchez to get out of bounds and stop the clock. Yep. Give Amesbury another play or two. Think. Is it time for my tight end play, Andrew? What do you think?
The play action tight end over the top. I think we're in that range.
Arsenal in there at quarterback. Martin, Sanchez, and O'Neill in the backfield. Arsenal rolling to his left, looking. He's going to fire out there, and it's complete. And caught by number 10 for Amesbury, Christian McGarry.
Nostradamus Gerzak to my left here. Calls the play action to the tight end. That was fantastic. You know, McGarry just ran a simple little out and up and out, and he was able to find him for an easy completion.
Twenty-five seconds remaining here in the first half. Still with the ball is Arsenal looking over the middle. He's going to float it out there, and it's going to be complete. And a touchdown to O'Neill. What a play. Henry O'Neill wide open. And that play took an awful lot of time to develop. But Luke Arsenal threw that one up from about 30 yards out there. Avery will go for two. Hand off inside, and this time looks like it's good. One receiver to the top side, one to the near side slot. And they're going to run it again, but again, nice tackle out there by number 9 for Ainsbury, Damian Capone. And that's going to be the end of the first half with the score, Amesbury 32, Ipswich 0. Bear with us, folks, as we're having a little bit of technical difficulty with our monitors and stuff tonight. So if we don't see everybody, it's because we can't see them. Cutting back inside is number 7, pushing forward, just driving as Martin. Aldoni at quarterback for Ainsbury. Hands off again, this time to the outside back, and barreling over the side there is Arsenal. O'Neill, Arsenal, and Martin right to left. And off this time to Arsenal. Arsenal, burst of speed right up the middle and into the end zone for a touchdown. 24-yard run by Luke Arsenal.
Yeah, that was just effort right there. He got a nice burst of speed. He took a hit around the 5-yard line or so, but just wasn't going to be stopped, dragged him in. And it's just more of the same. It's Ainsbury lining up and running the ball wherever they want. 24 yards for that one.
Handoff looks like to, who was that over there? O'Neill?
Martin.
Nick Martin that time with the PAT. slot man in motion goes McGowan. Hand off to the first back through and met at the line of scrimmage and driven back. Probably a yard or two gain that time by Wright. Donovan calling signals, man in motion, pitch back to Wright. Wright's looking to get around the corner, and he's going to be cut down. Look at that number one out there again.
Yep.
And Saldoni also out there to make the real first hit. Saldoni in that quarterback. Hands off to run around the side. That's Cox, I believe. He's going to be smacked after about a four-yard gain. And off to Sanchez. Maximus. Maximus breaks it into the outside. Looking down the right sideline, and he's going to be cut down on an open field tackle. So nice run that time by number 25, Maximus Sanchez.
Speed runs in that family as he took the handoff, and it was just a foot race. Louis Harrington did great to take a good angle and run him down.
And off to the right side, cracking through there, and in for the touchdown. Ainsley will go for two here. Hand off over to the left side, and going in, standing up, I believe, is Sanchez.
Yeah. So clock is now running. We have gone over the 42-point threshold in the third quarter. It is 48-0.
Do a second half summary here, Reggie.
All right, so in the third quarter, Arsenal with a 24-yard touchdown run, a nice speed run up the middle. Benjamin Richard with a 5-yard touchdown run. 2-point conversions after both, one by Martin, one from Maximus Sanchez. 48-0. Ainsley's got a lot of symmetry here. Two touchdowns and 2 2-point conversions in each quarter so far for your 48-0. I think we have some history being made here tonight right now, Frank.
Ah.
Just, he just came in the game?
Yes, I did. Be my guest.
Miss Dabanshi Jane, who, if I'm correct, is the first female to ever take a snap or get live game action for Ainsley High football.
And she was in the backfield. Dabanshi Jane is the center back here. Gets the handoff, drives forward.
And she got a first down just then, too. In the end, a football player is a football player.
6:25 remaining. Two receivers to the top side, two to the near side. Donovan looking to pass. He's going to air it out, but we have a whistle. And
yeah, they said they never get the playoff.
That's going to be the game as the official time is kept on the field. And That'll do it for this contest. The final score, Amesbury 48, Ipswich 0. O'Neill, Martin, and Sanchez in the backfield. Quick handoff over to the left side to number two, Henry O'Neill. O'Neill picks up a strong 5 yards. So third and a long one here for Amesbury. Up around the own 45-yard line. Hand off to the first back through and breaking it into the secondary is number seven, Martin, with a nice piece of running that time. Down inside the Pawtucket territory into the, call it 32-yard line. O'Neill, Sanchez, and Martin. Hand off this time to O'Neill along the left side. O'Neill breaks it into the secondary again. O'Neill breaks a tackle and pushes forward down inside the 30-yard line, down around the 25. And unfortunately, that one's going to be brought back. And off this time to O'Neill off the left side. O'Neill crashing in there into the secondary, very close to a first down.
Yeah, that was just to line him up and run right at him, and he did.
Third and two for Amesbury. Arsenal hands off again to Martin off the left side. Martin still dragging tacklers and has enough, I believe, for the first down. O'Neill, Sanchez, and Martin right to left in the backfield. This time, pitch back to Sanchez. Sanchez tries to get around the corner, makes a nice move, and still on his feet, driving forward, getting a little assist from behind, and still on his feet, and going to be enough for the first down. Good second effort. That's what you call team football.
Yes. Probably a good third, fourth, and fifth effort, too, there. So they wanted to get Sanchez and his elite speed out on the edge with the pitch, the lateral, which they did. And, you know, once he took the hit, then he turned into a power back and dragged a couple guys.
Arsenal hands off to number two. Off the left side goes O'Neill. O'Neill is in for the touchdown. All right, good second effort again by O'Neill as he was hit at the line of scrimmage and simply spun off to the left side. So Amesbury will get on the board first here. Yeah. Hand off inside to number seven. No, hold that. Arsenal still with the ball, and he's going to be in for the two-point conversion. So Luke Arsenal, another great fake into the line of scrimmage that time by Arsenal.
Out of it, and they're so dangerous out of it.
Yep. Oh, looks like an onside kick, and it may be recovered by Amesbury. Let's see what goes on here. So Amesbury with a little razzle-dazzle here to, after the touchdown, and they recover the onside kick.
Yeah, I think that was number 13, Hunter Belisle, that came up with that.
First quarter, 8-0 in favor of Amesbury. Once again, full house backfield for Amesbury. Hand off inside again to Sanchez. Sanchez plowing forward for some good yardage that time. We'll give him about 8 on that one. Side. Hand off this time to number two, O'Neill. O'Neill crashing through again, makes it into the secondary, has more than enough for a first down. So Amesbury, once again, very content to stay on the ground and just to grind it out.
They're playing Amesbury football right now. It's just run here, run there, run here, run there.
Split out to the near side this time of Sanchez. A little different formation for Amesbury. But handoff is inside again and breaking another tackle and into the secondary. Number seven, Dick Martin. We want to mention, too, that they've gotten a lot of good press here lately. But the front line for Amesbury, the offensive line, Will Arsenal, Aiden Donovan, Kyle Pale in the center, Daniel Hutchings, and Brady Nash doing an excellent job all season for Amesbury. Arsenal still with the ball, looking out here, fires it out there, and it's going to be complete for the touchdown to number nine, left tight end, Damian Capone.
Yes, great fake by Arsenal there, rolled out against the grain, and Capone just came off by his side and just ran a crossing route in the end zone. They bit on that fake really hard, and he just lobbed it over everybody, and Capone just basically had to wait for it, and he has the touchdown.
Hand off to O'Neill off the left side, and O'Neill is going to be in for the two-point conversion. O'Neal, Sanchez, and Martin. Hand off to number two, O'Neal. Off the right side again. Picks up some good yardage. Hand off again inside to number two. Nobody. Number one. There goes Arsenal off the left side. Again, another excellent fake into the line of scrimmage by Luke Arsenal.
Yep. When you're running, like I said, when you're running, you know, basically more or less the same formation, you know, there is going to be a fair bit of misdirection.
Arsenal directing traffic again. Hand off to the first back through. Sanchez almost breaks it. Sanchez very close to another first down here. Like I said, brought 8, 9, 10 people up into the box, and Ainsbury simply line opened them up, and dancing around here is number seven off the left side. Martin's going to have enough for a first down, I think, and he does.
He did a couple spins there, wound the grasp of the defender, and was able to get 4 or 5 extra yards on it.
Here. Drew Cialdoni at quarterback. Hands off to Arsenal off the left side. Arsenal inside the 5-yard line. So Luke Arsenal again. We know he can run the ball as well. And off to nobody, and waltzing in, uncontested, number 5, Drew Cialdoni.
Yeah, that, another fake there, that if he had handed it off, he would have scored easily too. But Cialdoni was able to, yeah, as you said, just waltz right in there. He just walked around the end, and they had sold out up the middle. And Ainsbury is in firm control now.
And off to Arsenal. Arsenal skips to the left side, jumps over, and going to be in for the 2-point conversion. Man in motion this time, number 20, carry on. High snap again, Igo gets the ball. He's going to be hitting the backfield, and he's going to be dropped for a loss. Number 3.
Yeah, Nico Cox fired off. He never got the corner there, and just kind of escorted him into not gaining any yardage until they blew the whistle. That was loss of 8 on that running play. We'll be right back.
Ritter split out to the near side. Top side is Carrion. Carrion in motion. He's going to get the ball again this time, and he's going to be hit, but gets off for one tackle and gently escorted again off the side of the field that time.
Yep. Sheldoni was there initially to force him out there, and then Nico Cox, with a little help from Luke Arsenault, escorted him to the sideline. And it's third and approximately 14 miles.
Arsenault. Barking signals, hands up, right up the chute, and again, some tough running inside there by Sanchez. Sanchez been going inside tonight as opposed to, trying to get around the outside. I mean, we've seen Sanchez last year and actually this year a few times. Once he gets into that secondary, man, he can turn on the Jets. Minute and five running clock here. Arsenault looking to pass this time. Looking downfield. He's hit once. Breaks one tackle. Still with the ball. Arsenault coming down the left sideline. It's going to be driven out of bounds right up around midfield. As Luke that time surveyed the field, had enough time to make calculations and decided to keep it. Off to the first back through and breaking it. Here goes Sanchez looking to get outside in a great open field tackle that time to save a touchdown.
Yep, that was that quick hitter, get the speed going. And before Pentucket even knew the play was going, he was in the secondary.
Martin, Sanchez, and O'Neill left to right. And off to the second back this time. And breaking it into the secondary is number two. And on his horse goes Henry O'Neill. He will be in for the touchdown. Henry O'Neill, 35-yard scamper.
Wow. That was a stiff arm for the ages there. And what happened, that looked like a disaster to start. He took the snap. Arsenault was getting tackled as he just kind of flung it off. O'Neill got out there, broke a couple tackles, and then threw, a Heisman Trophy statue-worthy stiff arm and was able to fight his way in there for the touchdown. That was just pure effort right there.
Martin, Sanchez, and O'Neill hand off to number seven. Martin. Martin is going to be in for the two-point conversion.
I think it was 2:18 inside their own 20. And they scored.
Donovan booms the opening kickoff, and that's going to bounce all the way down and picked up inside the 5-yard line by Pentucket, and he's going to be hit from the blind side. And who is that?
Luke Arsenault.
he's not going to make it. All right. So that'll do it. The score, Amesbury 32, Pawtucket nothing at halftime. Pawtucket at quarterback, Johnny Igo, the lone back. Two receivers to the top side, one to the near side. Hand off to Igo. Igo is stripped down and simply slammed to the turf again by number 8, Andrew Baker. All right, third down, and let's call it 8 for Pawtucket. This time, an inside reverse, and hit in the backfield is number 2, Henry Hartford that time. So as soon as I say that, they do come up with something a little bit different that time and tried an inside reverse.
Yeah, I think we're going to emphasize the word tried because they got blown up on that really quickly.
From their own 40-yard line. And off to the left side, dancing around is number 2, O'Neill. O'Neill has enough, I believe, for another first down, and he does. Saldoni at quarterback. Hands off to Arsenal. Arsenal off the left side. Arsenal is off to the races. Cuts back in and is finally tackled. Open field. Nice run back by number 1, Luke Arsenal. First and a whole bunch for Amesbury. Hand off inside again. And a little pass out in the flat, and it's complete down sideline. Driving forward, McGarry with a nice catch again. And Saldoni was hit pretty hard on that, but he delivered the ball again. He floated it out there. And McGarry, nice job that time. But second and make it 20 for Amesbury after the penalty. Hand off inside again and crashing forward, still going with some authority, Nick Martin. Arsenal and Martin, right to left in the backfield. Hand off to nobody. Still with the ball is Saldoni. Saldoni driving down, gets a nice block on the outside, and he's in for the touchdown. Great block on the outside that time. My number 8, Andrew Baker, to lead that charge. Hold on, he hands off to Martin. Martin's going to waltz his way in. So Martin gets in for the PAT. Mesner, high snap again. Hand off to Igo. Igo is going to be stood up in number 13 over there, Hunter Belisle. Pitch back this time to Sanchez, trying to get outside. Sanchez breaks one tackle in, has enough for a first down. That's going to do it for the third quarter. The score, Amesbury 40, Pawtucket 0.
Yep, you have one score there in the third quarter. Shaldoni with that excellent quarterback scamper for 20 yards. And then Martin added the two-pointer, make it 40-0 at the end of three. You are going to have the running clock in the fourth quarter now. It is at least over 32 points.
Hand off to number 14, right up the chute. Benjamin Richard all the way. Benjamin Richard blew it off the right side that time and blasted.
What do we got?
56 yard run.
Oh, that's what they were looking for on Sanchez all game, but they've been keying on him. Richard with a Sanchezian run, I think that's the word.
Up the middle,
and before the second level, before the safeties could even react, he was already gone. Massive burst of speed.
See if Pawtucket decides to kick it down or go for the onside. Looks like an onside attempt here.
Picked up by 20, Mike Sanchez.
Sanchez breaks it, almost gets in there, and Sanchez covers it all the way over to the Pawtucket 40-yard line. So. Number 12, Justin Doobie, a freshman quarterback in there for Amesbury. Hand off to number 14 around the right side is Richard again. Richard breaks another tackle into the secondary and picks up some good yardage. Speaking of which, right through the hole, number 21, the Banshee Jane. In case you haven't heard, folks,
she is
young lady,
one of the first to play for Amesbury, and she just ripped off about 10 yards there, and I got the first down.
So and that's going to be just about all she wrote, however.
If you look at it, Sheldoni had two, O'Neill had two, Arsenal had the pass to Capone, and Richard had one. So, you know, sometimes you'll see one guy piling up three or four touchdowns. No, and even the two-pointers, they were all over the place as well. Martin got in on that act as well, and it was a total and complete team effort all the way around.
We want to thank... Okay, we're back in the same usual foundation. Hand off to the second back through and powering forward, driving. Number two is Henry O'Neill. Close to a first down. He's going to be shot, but, well, check that. First down. In Arsenal. Hand off to Arsenal. Arsenal breaks it. Arsenal down the left sideline on his horse. Luke Arsenal's going to go all the way in for a touchdown. Beautiful piece of running that time. About a 60-plus yard touchdown. Beautiful piece of running. Full house backfield again for Ainsley. They will go for two. Hand off to Martin off the right side, and he's going to go in standing up for the two-point conversion. Two receivers to the near side. Hand off to number 10 off the left goes Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald is going to be stopped in the backfield. Might have got back to the line of scrimmage, so two good defensive plays here so far for Ainsbury. Martin, Arsenal, and O'Neill. Martin gets it on the right side. Martin looking for some daylight, gets to the outside, still on his feet, driving forward and up for another first down for Ainsbury. Boston Latin, nice kick. Melkonian gets it, and he's going to be immediately slammed to the turf.
Yeah. Andrew Baker was right down there. You know, almost a carbon copy of the Boston Latin Academy punt play.
We'll be right back.
spread formation again. Three receivers to the near side, one to the top side. Looking to pass to Shapiro. He's going to air it out downfield, and it's going to be incomplete. Number five, Sheldoni on that. On the near side, two on the top side. Shapiro dropping back, looking to pass over the middle, fires, and it's going to be picked off. Sheldoni down the right sideline, getting some blocking, still on his feet, finally corralled inside the 25-yard line. Martin, Sanchez, and O'Neill, left to right on your screen. Hand off to number seven, Martin. Martin dancing through the line, driving towards the goal line, and he's in for the touchdown. Excellent. Second effort again by number seven, Nick Martin.
Yep, simple. Hand off, run up the middle, and got a bunch of yards after contact and was able to fight his way in for six more. I think he kept it.
.249 remaining here in this first quarter. Donovan booms another good kick. Takes a nice high bounce and mishandled, but good open field tackle again. Who is that number one?
Luke Arsenault. Probably good time to point out that two-thirds of the earth is covered by water, the other third by Luke Arsenault.
Pitch back this time out to number two, Elston. Elston's going to be run out of bounds. So good coverage by Ainsbury's defense.
Yeah, it looked like McGarry, Sheldoni, Donovan, all involved in that.
Shapiro handoff inside again, and good coverage by Ainsbury as they're just stringing it out along the line of scrimmage, and Latin Academy here is not getting too far downfield.
Had their way. They've had the punt once, but you know, otherwise they've done everything they've wanted to do so far, offensively and defensively.
All right, third and a tough one here for Ainsbury. Sheldoni back in at quarterback. Hand off to the first back through, and crashing through there is Sanchez. almost broke it, more than enough for the first down. Drew Schaldoni, blocking signals. Schaldoni hands off on the right-hand side. Martin looking for some daylight, tries to get around the corner, makes it, cuts back in, and picks up an extra 5 or 7 yards. Martin in the backfield. Hand off to Martin around the right side. Gets a block, cuts back into the middle. Martin into the secondary. Still on his feet. Going down. He could go all the way. Nick Martin inside the 5-yard line. Down to about the 1.5.
Yeah, he ran over people on that run.
Hand off to the first back through is Martin, and he waltzes in for the touchdown.
Yeah, so he showcased the full toolbox of running back moves to get down there, and then just the ball ahead for the 6 points.
Hand off to Arsenal. Arsenal goes in untouched.
Yeah, that line is the engine that makes this race car go. And this race car is at top speed, full efficiency right now. They've done everything they've wanted to do so far.
And this time booms another one. It takes a bounce and it's misplayed again. Melkonian is going to be brought down. Shotgun formation, handoff to number 88. He took the quick snap again, O'Neill. So O'Neill, he's listed on our program as a tight end, but he's been taking the shotgun snaps here the last few times around.
It's like they're running a version of the Wildcat.
And four back tight formation here. Interesting. Also number 50 in here. A keeper again by number 88, O'Neill. And they'll be short of the first down, so they'll bring up a third down. Number number 12, Shapiro's back in there. This time he hands off to Elston. Elston around the right side. He's got about a yard or two. Little scrum going on here the last few plays, but again, Boston Latin Academy content to keep the ball on the ground. Direct snap again, handoff inside to number 10, Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald almost a fumble, but play was ruled dead. You get back to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, whistle. You can hear the whistle before the ball came out.
Along with Idaho and Fitzgerald. Shapiro looking to throw it again. Here comes the rush. Shapiro is going to be hit and dropped.
So, yeah, Capone and McGarry Associates on that play. He had guys there, but he just had those two in his face. He just could not get that pass off.
Stay tuned, folks. We're going to have a special presentation tonight honoring former AHS athlete and football player Troy Marden, who tragically passed away in 2019. Well, hopefully folks are enjoying your broadcast on Amesbury Community Television. As you said, Edu, Boston Latin Academy will start off here in the second half. Picked up around the 15-yard line. Good open field tackle out there. Spun him around. Who's that, number 13? Hunter Belial.
The theme of special teams coverage tonight has been one of violence. Quick violence. Everybody was getting swarmed trying to return the ball.
Direct snap again to O'Neill.
You know, running their regular rush offense and not getting anywhere, running that, you know, heavy backfield with the tight end running it, I have kind of a wildcat, was effective but slow. You know, I think they're going to have to start, you know, putting it up in the air.
Jack Shapiro at quarterback, hands off inside, and again, hit at the line of scrimmage is Fitzgerald.
Amesbury's winning on the run plays. They're winning the battle of the line of scrimmage consistently here.
Shapiro looking to throw the ball. He's going to be hit and dropped from the blind side. Number 10, Christian McGarry.
That's his second sack of the game there.
Handoff inside this time. Cracking in there and pulled down from behind. Shapiro throws it out in the flat again. And this time, Ainsbury covers it very well. O'Neill gets the snap again. O'Neill is pushed to the side, breaks in the tackle, but he's going to be stood up and... Again, gets the direct snap. This time, exit to Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald is stood up with a big hit again. Big hit that time. Who is that? Number 56 in there for Ainsbury, I believe. At least one of the charges. Aiden Donovan.
Yeah, Donovan. Looked like McGarry was there. Looks like Nico Cox was in there. He was able to penetrate as well. And stood him right up.
Third and goal from the five. Direct snap to O'Neill. He's going to run it again. This time he's going to be pushed back. I don't believe he's got it. No whistle yet.
Fourth down.
Who's that again? Number 56.
Aiden Donovan. He's had a Teddy Bruschi type of game. He's just been everywhere, and he's been a revelation at linebacker.
Same setup again. This time a receiver split out to the right.
Run pass option could be in play here.
O'Neill and Fitzgerald. O'Neill's going to try it again, and I don't think he's got it. I do not think he's got it. Ainsbury holds on. Four downs inside the 5-yard line. Great stand. Sanchez Scamper. He's in there. And they give it to Sanchez. He breaks it into the secondary. Oh. Nostradamus strikes again.
He does.
Beautiful piece of running. Almost broke it completely.
Yeah, that those are the Sanchez specials. You know, you pin deep. All of a sudden,
I think he likes it very deep in his own territory. Hand off inside and breaking it again into the secondary. O'Neal drives forward, and it looks like right this minute in this particular position on the field that Boston Latin Academy is putting eight guys in the box here.
Before, a hard count might go a long way.
Sanchez
here.
Is in the slot to the left this time. Hand off again, and looks like a first down, and O'Neal has the first down. Beautiful offside blocking out there. Two backs in the backfield. Slot man to the right is Sanchez. Arsenal hands off to Martin around the right side. Cuts back to the middle. Still spinning and diving and cracking forward. Got three downs, they can do this. Let's see what happens. And Luke Arsenal is going to take a knee.
Academy seems to have conceded. They had the right idea, the ball control, but they were behind 24 before they decided maybe that would be the best idea. Had they done that right from the get-go, might have been a different game, but Ainsley, did what they wanted too. It was hard to stop them. 62-yard run was really what got them going and put it away.
So Ainsbury will come out of here with a victory. Excuse me, Ryan Gleason, the quarterback, lone man, loses the football, and we may have a fumble recovery right off the bat here, and Ainsbury does recover.
Yeah, so the weather has already played a role when I played from scrimmage in. Gleason was not able to get the handle on it, and Damian Capone was able to dive on it before he was able.
Luke Arsenal at quarterback. Arsenal hands off to Sanchez. Right up the middle. Sanchez goes in totally untouched. A beautiful fake to the line of scrimmage. And a better fake that time by Michael Sanchez as he simply put that in the stomach and just jaunted gingerly into the end zone.
Yep.
Untouched.
Yeah, he could afford to because he used his burst of speed, got through the hole. And by the time the defense had reacted, he's already got 6 points.
Ainsbury will go for two. Full house backfield this time. Hand off to the first back through, banging off the left side. Going to be very close. Let's see what they spotted. And looks like Martin is. Donovan does a squibble kick. It's going to be an onside kick, and it's going to be enough for a first down here. Ainsbury recovers an onside kick. So Ainsbury going all out here.
Luke, the show Arsenault, was able to jump on that one.
So Ainsbury, first and 10, full house backfield, right to left. Handoff outside to number two, running around the left side. Here goes another loose ball, O'Neill, and recovered by Martin. Hand off to Sanchez off the left side. Sanchez blasts over for another first down, I believe. Second and goal from the four. And off the right side to Martin. Martin's going to dance on the right side. And who's that? I'm sorry. Arsenault again. I'll tell you, great fake into the line of scrimmage again by Luke Arsenault. Sorry about that, Luke.
Had just about the whole stadium fooled, especially the Millbury defense. You had 21 players collapsing in on the line of scrimmage right there. And the 22nd had the ball. Arsenault, who just kind of... was able to get the corner and get in for the injury touchdown.
Donovan to do the honors. This time another squibble kick off to the left side. It's not going to be done. Too far. Another loose ball. Let's see what happens here. Let's see what we get. Let's see what the referee says.
Ainsbury ball again.
Oh, another turnover.
And that one wasn't even on purpose either. That was just a squib kick that on the wet, sloppy, muddy turf that kind of squirted out from the guy. Yeah.
Gleason will run it too. Looking to go right, he's going to run it, and he's going to be stood up and dropped by Nick Martin. Big hit that time by Martin. Yep. Two series of first downs. Gleason with the run again. This time he's going to be hit from behind again. Number 55 out there, Will Arsenault.
Arsenault and Martin have been everywhere on defense. Now I'm...
Hernandez, the lone back, three receivers to the top. Looking to pass out in a flat. Going to flop it out there, and it's going to be intercepted. Going down the left sideline. Still on his feet, driving forward, but running out of gas is number 8 for Ainsbury. Andrew Baker. So another turnover.
Well, we figured Baker was going to get the ball, just didn't realize he was going to be on defense like that.
Leeson looking to pass again. Good defense. He's going to be smothered. Excellent tackle that time out there by number 10, Christian McGarry. That's a big loss. Big play.
Yeah, he broke through with Baker right at the same time, and McGarry was the first to get to him and take him down for make it a third and really long now.
Man in motion this time. Hand off to nobody. And dropped again in the backfield is Gleason.
Capone, Baker, all over it.
Enough inside. And up, still outside. Sheldoni that time. I think he has enough for the first down. Very close to it. Good, good fake into the line again. Let's see where they spot it. Going to be about a yard short. Sheldoni first back through on the right side, cracking in here and driving for a couple of tough yards and still on his feet. O'Neal driving forward for a great second effort again.
Yeah, very high yak on that play, yards after contact. He got hit 2 or 3 yards down, he got another 5 out of it. Just kept the feet moving. O'Neal seems to be shaken up a little bit.
Yeah. Hand off to nobody again. Around the left side goes Sheldoni. Sheldoni has enough for a first down, I do believe. Sheldoni at quarterback. Sheldoni hands off to Martin off the right side. Martin driving forward again, pushing, driving, and enough for a first down again. So Ainsbury is going to be inside the first, inside the 10. Sheldoni off the left side, crashing forward over there is O'Neill. So O'Neill gets a nice run off the left side that time. Good front, good up front blocking by the Amesbury offensive line. Will Arsenal, Aiden Donovan, Kyle Palin at center, Daniel Hutchings, Brady Nash. So Hunter Belai is in there for Martin. Hand off to number two. Nobody. Off the left side goes Sheldoni, and he's going to be in for the touchdown. Number five, Drew Sheldoni.
So, Frank, what did they run there on that one, do you think?
Exactly what you called, sir.
All right. You know, felt right the right time for it. It was, and he...
Martin's back in there on the left to right. Hand off inside and crashing in is good for the number seven, Nick Martin. This time, two lead blockers in there with Gleason. Gleason, though, looking to pass. Rolling out to his left this time. Still looking, still looking. He's going to be hit again and dropped. Just too much time. Too much time for Gleason that time. Give the secondary of Amesbury some credit again. Just had everybody covered. Sanchez back in the backfield, gets the pitch back. Sanchez looking for some running room. Sanchez breaks it into the secondary and is hit from behind.
Yeah, just the speed there. And a little bit of tough running, too. We don't give Sanchez enough credit for the tough running part of it. We always talk about his speed, but he just ran.
Well, his speed got him through the line.
It did. But then his toughness got him right out of a tackle. He just ran through an actual tackle there.
Second down, what did I say?
Up over the top.
Maybe.
Maybe to Andrew Baker, the touchdown maker.
I like it. If they run the ball, that's going to eat up a lot of the clock.
Yep, Sanchez is in there too.
Hand off to nobody, pass over the middle, it's complete to number two, O'Neill. O'Neill's going to dance in for the touchdown.
The Gurzak special. 4-6.
Good call, Coach McQueen.
Yes.
Luke Arsenal again at quarterback. Martin Sanchez and O'Neill. Hand off to nobody. Arsenal scoots back inside, and he's going to be in standing up. So a little mishandle in the backfield that time, but Luke Arsenal goes in for the two-point conversion.
Amesbury 30, Millbury 0 at the half.
Unexpected by all imaginations, as we said, the number 4 and the number 5 team coming into this quarterfinal playoff. Charbonneau on the kick, squibbles it off to the right, left side here. Picked up, looking for some blocking, up the chute. Here we go again. Off to the races. Number 20, Sanchez, could go all the way. And he's going to go in for the touchdown. Absolutely unbelievable. What can you say about this, Edu? I mean, Amesbury, you said they're doing everything right. They just did more than everything right.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Excellent burst of speed again as Sanchez picked it up on the fly. Got up into the line where most of the players were defensively and simply scooted through a little gap there and outraced everybody for the touchdown.
Yeah, you described it perfectly. They kicked right to him. That was the first kickoff return of the game. Nobody has not had an opportunity to kick off, and he just used his speed, and everything is going absolutely right for Amesbury right now. Everything's coming out Mount Halls for him. They need 36 points in about 31 minutes.
Three receivers to the near side, one to the top side. Is that pass out on the flat again? And an excellent hit by Sanchez. I think if he had waited a half a second, he might have picked that one off.
Yeah, and the thing was, though, that he gave Sanchez, the quarterback that gave Sanchez the opportunity to get there.
Two blockers in the back there again for Gleason. Hand off inside, and again he's going to be stopped in the backfield.
And that sums up Millbury's night right there. Nick Martin, who's been everywhere, was right where he needed to be, stuffed the fourth down run.
Slot man this time is Sanchez, O'Neill, and Martin in the backfield. Hand off to Martin. Martin's going to go inside and still on his feet looking to get out there. And good second effort again by Nick Martin.
Yep, your basic run off the right side there.
O'Neal, rather, I'm sorry. Hand off to O'Neal off the left side. Dancing, hopping, skipping, running, pushing, and driving forward.
You did everything but tap dance there.
Quarterback in there, number 11, DiCarlo. DiCarlo, the ball goes over his head, a loose football again, and it's going to be recovered by Avery, I believe.
Capone again.
Capone picks it up. And after the first back through and driving forward, still pushing and driving is number two, Henry O'Neal.
Yep, straight power run. Just hand it off up
first
the
down.
Middle.
First down.
Yeah, first and goal. I'm within, looks like about the four from here, it looks like.
Sheldoni hands up and cracking through there is Arsenal. Where are we going to spot
in.
This one?
He's in.
In for the touchdown. Luke Arsenal. We've said this numerous times all season, this year, last year. Not the biggest player on the team, but he's got a big heart. And I tell you, he likes to play football, and he plays it exceptionally well.
Yep, and the running clock has officially started with the
Oh, picked it up off the ground and in for the two-point conversion. That one bounced the right way, I tell you. Drew Sheldoni took a hit on that one.
Yep, if it was a keeper of any sort, Milbury had it blown up, but Sheldoni was able to, I'm sorry, Arsenal was able to pick that up and saunter on in.
Tail passes it out here in the flat. Friedman is going to hit and be dropped.
Yeah, Robert Dalton was able to get out there. I thought for a moment there that where it was a backwards pass that he was going to load up and try to throw it there, but whatever he was going to do, he had no chance because Dalton was there so quickly.
Looks like 3:14 and I can't see the other one. 13, Belial.
Hand it off to 13, Hunter Belial.
So Hunter Belial picks up.
Milbury defense didn't see him either until he had about 5 or 6 yards.
Number 14, Benjamin Richard, who ran one back in the last game. Hand off inside again and breaking it out into the secondary and still on his feet, driving forward as Nico Cox. Loose football, though. And Milbury does recover, but a nice run there by Nico Cox.
Tried to do a little too much there.
He carried two players with him and, you know, just bouncing that ball.
Yep. When you're stood up like that, the ball's vulnerable.
Mateo in that quarterback still. Hernandez in the backfield. Mateo looking to pass it. He's going to air it out here to an open receiver, but it's going to be picked off by Amesbury down the left side and whipped out of bounds.
Number six.
Benjamin Berg, a freshman defensive back.
And that's going to do it, I believe. Amesbury is just going to let the clock run out. And the final score will be Amesbury 44, Millbury 7. In the quarterfinals of the MIAA Division 7 playoffs. Give some credit to this entire defensive team here for Amesbury. Andrew Baker, Brady Nash, Daniel Capone, Nick Martin, Hunter Belisle, Will Arsenal, Aiden Donovan, Nico Cox, Christian McGarry, Luke Arsenal, Henry O'Neill, Michael Sanchez, all played an outstanding, outstanding job. And what more can you say about this offensive outburst here by Amesbury? Well-deserved, and they actually, distributed the scoring pretty well tonight. It wasn't just one person scoring all the time. So excellent job by Amesbury's all three teams, including special teams. Hand the pitch back to Humphreys. Humphreys is hit in the backfield, powering forward for about a yard or two. He'll be pushed back. Ainsley almost jumped that time. Hand off to the left side to Humphreys. He's going to be stood up and dropped. Foley at quarterback. Barking signals. Pitch back. Double reverse over to number 20. Back in the backfield and hit and dropped for a good pursuit. Maldon is corralled over on the left-hand side and loses a couple yards on that one.
Christian McGarry, Michael Sanchez, among others, in on that tackle.
Pitch back to Sanchez, looking to get the block outside. Gets one block, breaks it into the secondary, still on his feet, driving forward over midfield and into West Boylston territory, up around the 43-yard line. So Michael Sanchez, Amesbury speedster, gets a nice block on the outside and scampers about 30 yards downfield. Line drive kick is going to be fielded nicely and immediately dropped to the turf. Good pursuit by Amesbury. Well, give Foley some credit here, the quarterback, as he's making the calls. Back inside again and breaking one tackle, but Ainsbury is going to come up nicely that time. Number nine, Damian Capone, made the initial hit in the backfield. That'll be the end of the first quarter with the score. West Boylston 6, Ainsbury nothing, but West Boylston on the move here. As we said, West Boylston is the number one seed in Division 7. Foley still with the ball around the left side, and good open field tackle by number one, Luke Arsenal. Hand off inside and bringing it to Sanchez. Sanchez on his horse all the way down to the 30, to the 20, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown by speedy Michael Sanchez. Done it all this year.
Biggest play of the year for Ainsbury. They were kind of in a rut there. Sanchez got the quick hitter. Once he got past that second level, off the races. There was no one catching him whatsoever for
81 yard. Excellent speed by Michael Sanchez. Luke Foley, the quarterback. Muldoon in motion. Hand off to the first back inside, and cracking over the right side for a couple of yards is McNamara.
It looked like Sheldoni and a couple others were in there, get him before he could really get too far.
Muldoon to the right side. Humphreys takes the direct snap, looking to get in, and let's see what they say. No good, so Ainsbury's defense holds on the point after. So with 6:13 remaining in the half, the score, West Boylston 12, Ainsbury 6. Kind of a line drive squibbler. We're gonna do the same thing again, and it's picked up right there. Nice job by the up lineman that time for Ainsbury, number 13, Hunter Belisle.
Yep, that's a well-coached team. You see the ball, specializing that man, get on it.
Doing his usual outstanding job. We appreciate it, Tony. Hand off to number two off the left side. O'Neill has enough of the first down. Going to be pushed back, but forward progress.
What patient running there by O'Neill. He got the ball. He's behind one of his, put his hand out to just kind of feel where he was going. Was able to cut and get a few more yards out of that. Didn't panic.
Hand off the left to Martin. Martin spins away from one tackle, carrying players all the way along and helped. I don't know if that's legal here, but number 79 for Ainsby, Kyle Palin, dragging.
We'll call you 14 yards of that.
Sanchez split out to the right again. Arsenal fires over the middle. It's complete and very close to a first down. We'll see where they spot it. And a referee says yes, first down. 1:02 remaining. Ainsbury still has three timeouts.
What a bootleg fake by Luke Arsenal there.
Full house backfield once again. Right up the shoot and diving for the goal line and just shy of the touchdown. Piece of hunting by Sanchez again.
And they have, you know, they have timeouts here too. They have, and they're going to take one.
First and goal from inside the one.
It is.
Sanchez in the middle, flanked. First quarterback sneak and in for the touchdown is Luke Arsenal.
Kept it the simplest play they could. Snap it and dive. And they were able to get there. 34 seconds left in the half. Going to be 24 minutes to Gillette. Whoever can handle that pressure the best is going to get it done. Ainsley's going to get the ball to open the half. You know, one key thing, Ainsley has not led yet tonight.
First and 10 for Ainsley from their own 19-yard line. Luke Arsenal at quarterback, handoff inside and breaking into the secondary. Good run, good second effort again by O'Neill. Hand off inside and again powering forward and enough, I believe, for a first down. Nick Martin, simply the power runner for Ainsby so far this year.
That was an all effort run.
And off to Sanchez again. Sanchez looking for some running room. Good run, a good 9 yards that time by Michael Sanchez, who's carried the ball quite a bit tonight, actually. Had you?
They're countering Wes Boylston's size with his speed.
Martin, Sanchez, and O'Neill, right to left on your screen. Hand off again inside, and this time O'Neill cracks it for another first down. McNamara in the backfield, in motion. Hand off to nobody outside, and stiff arm, but a good open field tackle over there by Sanchez as 20 on 20 as Muldoon goes down. Kicking here for West Boylston. This one takes a big bounce off on the far side. Looks like Martin looking out down the sideline. Martin dancing around, still on his feet. Smashing forward, dragging tacklers. What an excellent piece of running that time by number 7, Nick Martin.
That was the special teams return that they needed right there. Martin looked like he was hemmed in, and then looked like he was down. Then it looked like he was down a second time. And then Ainsley's going to have a short field. That sets up really well for Ainsley.
Still a full house backfield for Ainsbury. Bringing everybody here. Hand off to the first back through is Sanchez. Sanchez dances into the secondary. So after three quarters, the score, West Boylston 26, Ainsbury 12. But they have a good contingent of fans here that showed up from Ainsbury tonight. Also, West Boylston's got a pretty good group on this side as well.
Not easy to get here at 5 o'clock on a Friday.
Loose football. Let's see what happened here. Ainsbury says they recovered.
That could be a game changer. They do.
And they did. So loose football on the snap there. Ainsbury, deep in their own territory, has a chance here to get back in this ball game with 11 minutes and 6 seconds remaining.
That's exactly what they needed. They needed a stop. They needed something.
O'Neill, Sanchez, and Martin in the backfield. Arsenal at quarterback. Arsenal looking to pass, rolling to his left. Got some blockers out in front of him. He's going to keep it. Cuts back to the middle. Still on his feet. Has enough for a first down. So excellent job that time by Luke Arsenal.
Yeah, I think you're going to see more of those IPOs going forward, run pass options for the rest of the game here.
Pitch back this time to Sanchez. Sanchez dancing around the left side, cuts back to the middle. Mm-hmm. deep for Ainsbury. Punt is almost blocked. Not
I
a
think
very
he got
good
a
kick.
Piece of
he
it.
Got a piece of it, possibly.
Picked up and go.
Picked up off the left side and running down the sideline and finally tripped up is, who's that, number eight over there, Andrew Baker.
That was an extremely high IQ football play there because no one was really bothering with that. It was almost like Wes Boylston was acting like Andrew was covering the punt.
In there. This time hands off inside to number two, O'Neill. O'Neill off the left side, diving for the goal line. Is going to be shot.
Yeah.
Very close to another first down. Baker to the far side, Sanchez this time in the slot to the left. Arsenal looking to pass, he's going to be
he can go. He
confronted.
Can
he's going to fake the, and gets a big hit. He faked the pass and took a big hit. But what happens, once again, I'll tell you, Luke Arsenal jumps right up, says, okay, let's go for the next play.
Yeah, absolutely.
Saldoni in at quarterback, handoff on the left side and in for the touchdown. Who was that? Number seven, Nick Martin.
Number seven, Nicholas Martin.
Martin split to the top side. Sanchez and O'Neill in the backfield. Saldoni at quarterback. Hands off over there to number two and in for the points is number two, Nick Henry O'Neill.
So I'm going to put on my Nostradamus hat again. I'm going to predict that Ainsbury will perform an onside kick here.
So Ainsbury did it all the way into the semifinals this year of the Division 7.
Top four in the state.
Top four in the state. And this was a good matchup between the number one and the number four seed. All right, so final score for the final time. West Boylston, 30.
Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. It's time for the annual Newburyport Ainsbury Thanksgiving Day game. Today is the 99th edition of the rivalry.
There's a big hole.
Big hole there. That's my O'Neill again.
Yep.
O'Neill, he's got a first down.
Yep, big run by O'Neill. Huge hole. Good job of the Ainsbury offensive line there.
This time it's Martin.
Yep, Martin with a nice carry. Dragged the Newburyport defender with him for a little bit.
Full House backfield again. And Lassenaar rolls out to his right. Now he steps, makes a nice move.
Oh, he lost the ball.
No, it's picked up by Ainsbury, though. Right in the hands of Ainsbury.
Then there's a flag.
The middle. Oh, nice run. Oh, wow. That came out of nowhere. I didn't even see that.
Yeah, huge run by Sanchez.
He's got a variety of runners. Lined up in a straight line.
Yeah, it's the first time we've seen this formation. We'll probably go to the second one, though.
Or keep
caps it.
Arsenal carries the ball himself. And
should
he's
be in, yeah.
The touchdown. Arsenal, 2-yard touchdown. A two-point conversion attempt, and it's Arsenal on the keeper.
Captain, it's in,
and it's good.
Nice effort by the Clippers defense, but Arsenal was able to get in there.
Arsenal the run, and it makes Ainsbury 8, Newburyport 7, with
4:02
to go in the first quarter. Coming in motion toward us. Logan.
Miss block. Good defense.
Logan Jones.
Capone with the tackle for Ainsbury.
Fuller looks over the line, gets the pass, the ball, and he's going to get sacked. Big play by Ainsbury.
He had a chance to throw it and held on.
Good sack by Ainsbury. That was
Capone again. Capone. He said two big plays in this series. Saw a lot of O'Neal the first time. Let's see. But then Sanchez had the big run.
And there's another run right there. Sanchez again, right up the middle.
Tripped over his own feet. He might have been gone. Got to about the 49-yard line.
Another first down for Ainsbury.
That's the end of the first quarter.
And they're going to spot that at the 36-yard line.
That's the end of the first quarter of this morning ball game.
15 yards for Sanchez. Ball's the 37-yard line. And they could run there again, right up the middle. It's going to be shy. It's going to be close to the first down.
Looked like he was only going to get a 1-yard gain.
And that was
good job by O'Neal. O'Neal.
And that's going to be a touchdown. O'Neal.
He would have went for 100 yards there. There's a Clipper injured. It looks to be Haddon looks to be banged up.
16-yard run and a touchdown for O'Neal. For the two-point conversion here.
Up the middle again. Got it.
And it was...
I think it was...
Number seven?
Martin carries yep. The extra 2 points. It's going down Ainsbury 16, Newport 7.
So 16-7 in favor of Ainsbury. Martin with the two-point conversion.
Clock wasn't
Fuller
running.
Keeps the ball, and he's going to get it. It's a loss. Martin on the tackle.
Martin's had a good defensive game, too.
1 yard loss. Third and 11. Four, back to pass. Down the middle it goes, intended for Heavlin. It's knocked away by Ainsbury. Good job by O'Neal to knock that away. Four-yard line, first and 10.
Sanchez, it right up to Sanchez, yep.
Boy, look at him run to the 43-yard line.
Yeah, once he gets
line.
The ball, he just explodes. And it's right at the middle.
And he's going to get a 19-yard pickup.
Middle.
Another one.
This is O'Neal, I believe.
It's O'Neal. Yep.
Just up the middle, easy. Another 12 yards. Down.
That's Martin. He's going to have the first down. All right, first and 5, excuse me. And there's a flag on the play.
Yeah, he threw it with her, so I wonder if it's face mask or if it's going to be a chop lock on Ainsbury.
You see, that was O'Neal that carried
it. That Sanchez.
Yeah, that was Sanchez. I saw the two, all right. Arsenal kept it.
Yep, good fake. I thought it was a handoff.
Yep,
Arsenal
touchdown.
With a touchdown.
Nice ball handling. Yeah.
You know, notice with Ainsbury is Arsenal, he also plays cornerback, which we haven't seen that in a while, where the quarterback plays defense.
Three receivers out to the right. High snap. Fuller has it. He keeps it. And he's to the 50 and maybe to the 49. And he's pushed back.
But broke one tackle. And
see what he gave him. The forward progress should be to the Ainsbury
then,
49.
Then Aiden Donovan with a big tackle for Ainsbury. Two timeouts.
The pitch outside to Sanchez, going to the outside, 45 to the 50, inside Newburyport territory, tackled out of bounds.
They're going to mark him out at the 49.
That'd be enough for first down.
That's stuff. Here's the pass. Oh, he's got people
pass.
Open.
It's complete. And that was completed to number 8.
Andrew Baker.
Yep. Yeah, I was going to say, they've had a packed in offense the whole game. All right, Arsenal hands it off. It's going to be a halfback option, maybe.
It's throwing to Martin.
Throwing the ball. He's got a guy out there. It's complete down to the 4-yard line.
Ooh, Clippers think he dropped it, but...
Okay. Hand off.
Right up the middle. Yep, carried in there. Oh, he fumbled, but they're calling it a touchdown.
Yeah, he was over the line. Yep. That was Madden. Madden.
Yep. 6 seconds to go in the half.
Four-yard run for Madden.
Off the 20, Sanchez. He got it.
And the Sanchez with a run.
Sanchez carries the extra 2 points.
Ainsbury 30-7.
Squib.
And, a little bit there, but that's going to end up at a half.
Yep.
Took a long time for the whistle to blow, but.
It still kept fighting, but. Thank you. Ainsbury's cross-country team did well. Onside kick for Newburyport. Recovered for Ainsbury.
So Ainsbury would take over almost like a repeat of the first half.
Yeah.
Ainsbury's taking over the 50. Newburyport. So first and 10 for Ainsbury. Pitch out to Sanchez out the left side, and he's going to be inside the 45, maybe the 43. And is that O'Neill?
Yeah, O'Neill right up the middle. Big gain.
Again,
right
up the middle.
Boy, he's continuing to go. Wow.
Look at his drive.
Good job, offensive line.
That was Martin, I think.
Yep,
Martin.
Inside the 10 now. Looks like maybe the 8.
10, 9, 8-yard line, so it's 12-yard pickup. Calling out the signals. And it's
right
Sanchez. Sanchez spins forward and he's going to be close to the goal line.
Looks like he has.
And this looks like Martin.
Yep, right up the middle. Into the end zone.
Oops, and it's...
I think he got it.
And, yep.
I'm not sure who ran it in. Looks like it was Martin again.
Martin with a two-point conversion. But hopefully everything's all set and back to go. It's first and 10 Newburyport, 8:11 to go in the quarter. There's a pass to Jones. Jones at the 50 into the down to the 48-yard line.
Yep, good defense there by McGarry for Ainsbury. Sullivan looks like maybe got a 1 yard loss on it.
Hey,
right up the middle.
There's a run. This could be a big rain up to the 32-yard line.
Head and running Sanchez. And Walsh on the tackle for the Clippers.
Sanchez picked up 14 yards to the 32, first down. I'm all
right. Right.
Oh, Sanchez.
Huge.
Ooh,
one.
Nice tackle. That could have been all the way.
Yeah, Miles with a nice tackle. He saved a touchdown, maybe.
This must be Martin. Martin almost broke away there. He's inside the 45 to maybe 43.
Looks like it was going to be a one-yard gain, and he ends up getting 14 on it.
That's going to be down to Newburyport, 43. Arsenal keeps the ball himself.
Wow, ends up getting about 5 yards on the play. That might be the last play of the quarter. Yeah, and he's not that tall. So
I mean, I'm looking right at it. Even on the monitor, and I still can't tell who's got the ball. Arsenal gave it to Martin. And Martin has a first down.
Oh,
inside
they gave
the
him
20.
The first down, huh? The markers already have it at first.
Oh, they did.
I thought it was fourth and one.
Oh, well, I got to give. I thought so. They must have you. All right, so that. A conversion. So now he adds. Now this is going to be O'Neill. Was that Martin the last carry?
Yep.
And then this is O'Neill.
O'Neill probably got it to about the 4 yard line, it looks like. Maybe three. I think.
O'Neill spins forward inside the 15, maybe the 14.
O'Neill's ball carrier.
Yeah, it looks about the 14.
7 yard pickup for O'Neill. That's it. Game clock runs out. The season is over. As Newburyport scores 7 points. To 38-14, Amesbury is the final score.